हेलो एवरीवन, आज हम स्टार्ट करेंगे लेक्चर नंबर 8। और लेक्चर नंबर 8 के अंदर हमने जो टॉपिक अभी मेंशन किया है, दैट इज सिस्टम ऑफ सस्पेंडेड चार्जेस। लेक्चर नंबर 7 के अंदर हमने डिस्कस किया था कि जब भी कोई सिस्टम इक्विलिब्रियम में होता है, जब आप उसमें किसी भी पार्टिकल को अपनी पोजीशन से डिस्प्लेस करते हैं, वो वापस उसी पोजीशन पर आना चाहता है। दैट मींस वी डिस्कस अबाउट द सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन दैट ए चार्ज वाज एग्जीक्यूटिंग व्हेन द सिस्टम वाज इन इक्विलिब्रियम। एंड इन द सेम वे वी आर मार्चिंग टुवर्ड द सिस्टम ऑफ द सस्पेंडेड चार्जेस। हियर विद यू हैव टेकन द सिस्टम इन इक्विलिब्रियम। That does mean when you are moving these charges, they are again attaining their mean position, and that's why when you are taking these charges, you know that the electrostatic force is being exerted over each other. Okay, so now if I take the system like this, where L is the length of the string, and when these two charges are there of the mass m. Okay, now you see here a weight force will be, therefore the mass m Fe is there, that is the electrostatic force which this particle, the another particle of mass m will exert over it. Fine. Now this L is the length of the string, and when string is there, definitely there is a tension. जो खिंचाव होता है, जो मॉलिक्यूल्स होते हैं वायर के, दे विल बी चेंजिंग देयर पोजिशन, एंड दैट विल रिजल्ट इन ए रीस्टोरिंग फोर्स टू अटेन द ओरिजिनल पोजिशन for the molecules I'm talking about, and that restoring force is known as torque, this tension, sorry. So tension will exert like this, fine. And when you draw this diagram, you definitely see if this is theta, if this is inclined at theta, this is also theta. So the two component of the tension, that is a force, will be T cos theta, and this one is T sin theta. Okay. I hope you understand that this is a crash course, and these are very simple things for all of you who have gone through 11th and 12th class. Basically, in the 11th class, you have drawn the FBDs, free body diagrams, and you have the basic knowledge for the vectors. Okay, so the vector components, when you are just baking them or you are resolving them in the two components, rectangular components, and these are T cos theta and T sin theta. Okay. Now, then after, when you balance this, when the system is in equilibrium, definitely in horizontal direction and in the vertical direction, you will balance the system. That means T cos theta equals to mg and T sin theta equals to Fe. So suppose this one is first equation and that is the second equation. When you add them and square, squaring, adding, you will get definitely T square equals to Fe square plus mg. Fine, and thus the T will be Fe square plus mg. Okay, fine. If you see that this one is this triangle, suppose this triangle I'm taking, fine. Basically, when you see this is L, okay, and this L, when you find it, this is L cos theta, this is L sin theta, okay, and this is x by 2, this is x by. So when you calculate in this triangle, when you apply Pythagoras theorem, what will you get? You will definitely get that this is x by 2, okay, and this is, we have taken L, and this is perpendicular and this is hypotenuse. So perpendicular by hypotenuse will become sine theta. That means x by 2 into L, that means in this triangle x by 2 into L, x by, just wait, man, let me take the next space, x by 2 by L is sine theta. Okay, x by 2 L sine theta, that means x is 2 L sine theta. One approximation we are using, when theta is small and L is the length of the string, okay, this approximation will we will be taking now. But you see, from the first and one and two equation, ek result aapne tension nikali, dusra result aap kya nikal sakte hain, I'm just writing here, T is, we have calculated Fe square plus mg, right, mg whole square, just wait, okay, mg whole square. Now you also calculate 1 डिवाइडेड बाय 2, यू कैलकुलेट द टेंजेंट थीटा इक्वल्स टू एफ ई बाय एम जी. द इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक फोर्स डिवाइडेड बाय द वेट फोर्स विल बी टेंजेंट थीटा. एंड नाउ यू कैन कैलकुलेट टेंजेंट थीटा, इट मीन्स द एंगल थीटा हियर. फाइन, नाउ यू सी व्हेन थीटा इज स्मॉल, डेफिनेटली यू टेक व्हेन थीटा इज स्मॉल एंड एल इज द लेंथ ऑफ द स्ट्रिंग, देन यू कैलकुलेट एक्स. Calculate x, and that x is it. So x is 2l sine theta. Fine. And when theta is small, sine theta is basically approximately equal to theta. Fine. So from here, the sine theta is x by 2l. Sine theta is x by 2l. Fine. So sine theta comes out to be x by 2l here. And this x by 2l is equal to tangent theta. Okay, that's why this x by 2l will be equals to the tangent theta is f e by mg, that means k q square by x square into mg, and from here you can calculate your desired result. And this is, that is, let me add another piece. This is x is 2l k q square power 1 by 3 divided by mg. Okay, so now this one is giving you a beautiful result that this x, the separation between the charges, is directly proportional to 1 by 3 power of the length of the string. And in the next question I'm using it. For example, when the system of the suspended charges is like this is a question. So this is the height y, so the suspension is like this, and when you take it, the separation is r. When you lower down the suspension point, the distance is y by 2, then he is asking you a question that what is r is. Okay, so you can apply a simple method that you know that the separation, this one, is directly proportional to the length of this, and when theta is small, this y is approximately equal to the length of the string. So that means x is directly proportional to l raised to power 1 by 3, and when theta is small you know that y is length of the string. So you can apply this proportionality equation here to calculate your result. So first of all, I will write that this r is basically y raised to power 1 by 3. Okay, and in the second case, r dash is directly proportional to y by 2 raised to power 1 by 3. Okay, so these are the two results. Okay, and from these two results, you can simply calculate that r dash is r by 2 root 2 1 by 3. Okay, so in this way you can use that result which we have calculated for the suspended charges. In the next question, it is very easy to calculate. You see that when the suspension of the charges is like this, and in this structure and in this question you have a rod which is also charged, and when this is exerting a electrostatic force on this particle, on this body which is of mass m and q charge, so it will go like in this direction. So fe is there and the tension is there. Fine, and a mass mg is also you are calculating. So basically you see when you draw this, if this is theta, this is also theta, and if this theta is, ye 90 hai, so ye kya hoga, ye 90 minus theta hoga, this will be 90 minus theta by 2, this will be theta by 2, and this will be again 90 minus theta by 2. Fine, so here when you draw that, this is also theta by 2. Fine, so these are some angles. And now if you have, you see, I can solve this question by two methods. How? You see, you have this FE, this MG, and the tension is there. Okay, if you see that this angle and this angle, and you know that Lemmy's theorem. So Lemmy's theorem is what? When you apply like this is F1 and this is F2, this is F2 and this is F3, please do remember the Lamy's theorem in the vectors. Okay, so you calculate that this is, suppose this is alpha and this is beta, suppose this is f2 and this is f3 and this is beta and gamma. So what you say that f1 by sine alpha, suppose how do you remember this f1, the opposite angle, that does mean the sine of that opposite angle, f1 by sine alpha, f2 by, f2 ke opposite kaun sa angle hai, ye beta, so f2 by sine beta and then f3 by sine gamma. So this is the Lamy's theorem, and in the similar way you can apply here. Okay, so when you apply here the Lamy's theorem, you please do see that this becomes mg by sine 90 plus theta by 2 equals, ek force kaun si hai, fe hai, ek t hai, so t is by sine 90 plus theta by 2 and equals to fe by sine 180 minus theta. How it is, you please see the mg by sine 90 plus theta by 2. Okay, so mg is here. If you calculate this angle, this angle this will be 90 plus theta by 2. Okay, fine. And when you calculate this angle fe by sine, this will be 180 minus theta, and definitely the t will be sine 90 plus theta by 2, it will be 90 plus theta by 2. Please verify this from the diagram which I have given to you. This is a simple geometry. Okay, so first of all you have to just resolve the components of the tension or the force which you are taking, and then you can apply the Lamy's theorem, and from this it is very simple to analyze the result that this mg by, this will become cos theta by 2, this will be t by cos theta by 2, fine, and this will become sine 180 minus theta. You can say this is you see fe by, in the terms of it is sine theta, right, and you know that the sine 2 theta is 2 sine theta cos theta. Okay, and 2 sine theta cos theta, that does mean the sine 2 angle, double of the angle, equals 2 sine half the angle. So now here when it is sine theta, it will become 2 sine theta by 2 and cos theta by 2. Okay, from this two equations it is very clear that t equals to mg and equals to fe by, you can say this is 2 sine theta by 2. So this is the result. So now you can calculate t is mg, fine, and when it is asked that when you know the t, you can calculate fe. So fe is mg 2 sine theta by 2. Okay, so these are the equations, so you can calculate like this, fine. Ek method, the second method is, let me add one piece. In the same question, when you apply, let me draw the diagram again. The diagram was, you have the suspended mass here and suspended charge, it was there when it felt electrostatic force here, okay, like this. So basically I draw that this is theta, if this is theta then obviously this is theta and this is 90 minus theta, okay, and this angle is 90 minus theta by 2 and this is theta by 2, fine, and this is mg and this is t. When this t is, when you resolve the components, when you don't know what is Lamy's theorem and you don't know how to apply it, you please go to this method of resolving components. So now this is t cos theta, fine, and when this is t cos theta, definitely this will become t sine theta. The another one is, this is mg and this fe is there, if this is theta by 2 then vertically opposite angle this is also theta by 2. Okay, then again the component will be fe cos theta by 2, fine. So this is fe cos theta by 2, this is t cos theta, and this component, this one is t sine theta, okay, t sine theta, and this mg is what is the angle of it, this is how much left, 90 minus theta by 2, fine. Okay. Now the system is in equilibrium, and you when you state the state of the equilibrium, that does mean you are balancing the vertical and horizontal components. So you just balance the vertical and horizontal component. That is, you see the t cos theta is there, and in this direction Fe sin theta by 2 is also there. So in vertical direction you can say that t cos theta plus Fe sin theta by 2 equals to this vertical mg. So this one is equation number 1, and when you balance the horizontal, then that will be t sin theta. The question is t sin theta and equals to this is Fe cos theta by 2. So basically you have the two equations again, and when you solve them you will definitely get the results t. Okay, you can put the equations 1 or 2 in each other, and then you can calculate the t will again mg. I'm just leaving you for the homework, so you can calculate like this. In the next concept, it is very important concept, when the it is written over there that if the whole system is immersed in a liquid of the density sigma. So sigma is the liquid density, please do remember this. Okay, so this is the density of the liquid in which you are immersing your system of the charges. And when the system of charges was placed at a distance of, suppose whatever the distance between them. Okay, now it is saying that dielectric constant K, but angle of, और ये जो डायलैक्ट्रिक कांस्टेंट के है ये उस मीडियम का डायलैक्ट्रिक कांस्टेंट है, बट एंगल ऑफ द इक्विलिब्रियम रिमेन सेम, कैलकुलेट द के. ओके, तो आपको उस लिक्विड का डायलैक्ट्रिक कांस्टेंट निकालना है. तो आपको कह रहा है कि आपका ये एंगल चेंज नहीं होना चाहिए. अगर ये एंगल चेंज नहीं होना चाहिए, और फिर वो बोल रहा है कि दिस इज अ स्टेट ऑफ इक्विलिब्रियम, एंड व्हेन द स्टेट ऑफ इक्विलिब्रियम इज देयर यू आर सपोज टू कैलकुलेट डायलैक्ट्रिक कांस्टेंट ऑफ द मीडियम or the liquid in which your system is being immersed. Okay, so now how do I start it? You please, this is the density of the body which is having the charge Q. So do you have any idea how to start this problem? Yes, because you are immersing your system or a mass in a liquid, definitely it will feel bind force. Okay, so now you see W is mg, right? If I'm just simply drawing the FBD free body diagram, that is W equals to mg. And now in this case, this m can be written as density is mass by volume. So mass can be written as density into volume. So density of the body, not the liquid. This is the mass of the body, that's why density of the body, and then the volume, and this is V. Okay, if you do remember, this is the density of the charged body, or you can say density of the charge, and in other words this is the density of the body. And there, when you immersed in it, this mg will not be there. जैसे ही आप पानी में डालेंगे इसको, mg जो नीचे लग रही थी, bind force ऊपर लग रही है, so net weight force will be reduced. So W equals to mg minus the bind force. You can say bind force. This is bind force. Why I have marked this as a concept? This is also a question, and you please remember, I have selected those questions which are basically concept. You will learn many things. You will learn how to tackle many problems or the numerical problems from the standard books. Okay, these will be used as a concept. So you don't need to practice more and more questions. You just practice some 20-30 good questions again and again. Okay, so that it also becomes 100 or 150 or 200, definitely you will get something new. Okay, and the result will be definitely fair for you. And this is a bind force, and you know that when a mass, the density of the body is rho, and you are immersing in a liquid of the sigma density, then how much force, the bind force will be there? Density of the liquid in which liquid you are immersing in it. Okay, so जितना liquid ये बाहर निकालेगी उसके ऊपर depend करेगा कि उस पर bind force कितना लगेगा. हम लिखते हैं, क्या लिखते हैं? So this is mg minus सिग्मा द रो वी जी, याद है आपको? लेकिन अब यहाँ डेंसिटी किसकी है? वाटर की, लिक्विड की. ओके, रो वी जी, और दिस इज द वॉल्यूम ऑफ द डिस्प्लेस्ड लिक्विड. एंड इन द सेम वे यू कैन राइट इट, दिस बिकम रो वी जी माइनस सिग्मा वी जी. फाइन. नाउ इन दिस यू नो दैट एल्फा इज, वट इज एल्फा हियर? यू नो टेंजेंट थीटा इज, ऐसा ही मैंने आपको पहला डायग्राम बनाया था. टेंजेंट थीटा इज एम जी, टेंजेंट थीटा इज एम जी. ओके, सो टेंजेंट थीटा इज एम जी, बट हेयर आई एम टेकिंग टेंजेंट एल्फा इक्वल्स टू एफ ई बाय एम जी. ओके, ये जो कंडीशन थी ये जब थी जब आपने इमर्स नहीं किया. जब आपने इमर्स नहीं किया सो जैसे ही आपने इमर्स किया ये किसके बराबर होगा? एफ ई बाय एम जी डैश. यही तो मतलब हुआ कि एंगल चेंज नहीं होना चाहिए. तो आपने एंगल को लिखा कि कितना है, वो चेंज नहीं होना चाहिए, वो भी आपने लिखा. सो जब आपने बाद में लिखा, जब वो इमर्स किया आपने, सो दैट डज मीन यू आर नॉट चेंजिंग द एंगल बिटवीन देम, एंड दैट कैन ऑल्सो बी अचीव्ड बाय दिस इक्वेशन. ओके, सो नाउ यू पुट दिस, दिस वन इज एफ ई बाय रो वी जी इक्वल्स टू, दिस इज एफ ई, दिस इज ऑल्सो नॉट चेंजिंग, एंड दिस एम जी डैश इज, यू से क्या बना था ये जो नया एम जी मतलब नया वेट फोर्स बना था, वो अभी आप निकाल के आए हैं, कितना बना था? दैट वॉज के रो वी जी माइनस वी सिग्मा जी. ओके, आपको पता है दिस विल बिकम के टाइम्स, जितना डायलैक्ट्रिक कॉन्स्टेंट होगा मीडियम का उतना टाइम्स वो उससे के टाइम्स हो जाता है. सो जब आप इसको सॉल्व करेंगे डेफिनेटली विल गेट द के विल बी रो बाय रो माइनस सिग्मा. सो दिस इज अ वंडरफुल रिजल्ट दैट व्हेन ए बॉडी ऑफ डेंसिटी रो इज इमर्स्ड इन ए लिक्विड ऑफ डेंसिटी सिग्मा. एंड वट इज द सिचुएशन? प्लीज डू रिमेंबर, दिस इज अ सस्पेंशन ऑफ द चार्जेस एट एंगल थीटा, एंड द सिचुएशन इज वेन यू आर प्लेसिंग इट इन ए लिक्विड ऑफ डेंसिटी सिग्मा, एंड दीज बॉडी विच आर एट एंगल थीटा आर हैविंग डेंसिटी रो. इन दैट केस यू कैन कैलकुलेट दैट द डायलैक्ट्रिक कॉन्स्टेंट ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर मीडियम विच यू आर टेकिंग इज रो बाय सिग्मा रो माइनस सिग्मा. सो प्लीज डू रिमेंबर दिस. इन द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इट इज वेरी सिंपल. इफ चार्ज फ्रॉम बोथ स्फीयर लीक आउट विद कॉन्स्टेंट रेट देन अप्रोचिंग वेलोसिटी इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू. कह रहे हैं इन दोनों चार्जेस, इन दोनों से जो चार्ज हो रहा है वो लीक हो रहा है. ओके, और डेफिनेटली जब चार्ज लीक होगा सो नेगेटिव विल बी क्रिएटेड एंड दिस बॉडी विल अट्रैक्ट ईच अदर. सो इन दैट केस दिस अप्रोचिंग वेलोसिटी इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू, एंड द ऑप्शन आर एक्स वन बाय एक्स रूट एक्स, दिस इज द एक्स डिस्टेंस बिटवीन दैम. ओके, यू कैन स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द टेंजेंट थीटा, दिस वन इज थीटा एंड दिस इज थीटा. ओके, वहाँ एल्फा कितना था, यहाँ एल्फा कितना था? थीटा बाय टू यू कैन से. ओके, तो दैट वॉज एफ ई बाय एम जी. एंड नाउ क्यों था ऐसा? क्योंकि ये हमने माना था थीटा बाय टू एंड थीटा बाय टू. वहाँ टेंजेंट थीटा निकाल रहे थे क्योंकि उनके बीच में एंगल कितना था? टू थीटा था. देख रहे हैं आप, फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन में दिखा रहा हूँ आपको, देखिए यहाँ टू थीटा एंगल था और थीटा कितना आया था? तो उसका हाफ आया था टेंजेंट थीटा. तो यहाँ पे भी अल्फा कितना आएगा? थीटा बाय टू आएगा. सो लेट मी स्विच टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. दिस क्वेश्चन इज बेसिकली वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. यू सी इफ यू राइट टेंजेंट थीटा यू कैन राइट, यू हैव डिराइव द रिजल्ट दैट टेंजेंट थीटा इज एफ ई बाय एम जी. ओके, एंड दिस इज बेसिकली परपेंडिकुलर बाय हाइपोटेन्यूज, एंड यू वेन यू सी दिस इज एक्स बाई टू एल, राइट? एंड इन दैट केस एक्स बाय टू एल कैसे आया था? एक्स बाय टू इज अ परपेंडिकुलर एंड एल इज द हाइपोटेन्यूज, सो नो कॉम्प्लेक्स मैथमेटिक्स इज देयर. ओके, सो दिस विल यू कैन राइट एफ ई बाय एम जी, एफ ई बाय एम जी इक्वल्स टू एक्स बाय टू एल. फाइन, सो एफ ई इज के क्यू स्क्वेयर बाय एम जी इन टू वट इज द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन दैम? एक्स स्क्वेयर, एंड इट इज एक्स बाय टूएल. ओके, सो फ्रॉम दिस यू कैन फाइंड आउट दैट एक्स क्यूब is directly proportional to q square, or you can say the q is directly proportional to x raised to power 3 by 2. Okay, what do you mean by the leak out and with constant rate? So rate of leaking out, that means with respect to time. So definitely you will differentiate it with respect to time. It will become dq by dt, and it is 3 by 2 x raised to power 1 by 2. Okay, this is what, just wait, I'm just, you can write it as like this. Differentiation karenge to aap isko kar liye, 3x square dx by dt, and this is 2q dq by dt. Fine, and this dq by dt is, let me write it again, this is x cube directly proportional to q square. So this is 3x square dx by dt equals to 3q square dq by dt. It was x q square, sorry. So this is 2q. Let me erase it. Okay, so this is 2q dq by dt. Fine, so you are with this equation, and with this dq by dt is a rate of leaking out, and this is given as constant. Okay, if this is given as constant, you calculate this dx by dt is v, the velocity of approaching. Okay, so this will become v, and this is 2q, and dq by dt is constant, so definitely this v will become q by x square, right? अब बाकी चीज़ें, सारी चीज़ें इसको कांस्टेंट लेंगे, एक्स स्क्वायर नीचे जाएगा. मैं अभी वो फैक्टर्स नहीं ले रहा 2, 3 वाले, आपको सिर्फ प्रोपोर्शनलिटी देखनी है. सो वी इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू क्यू बाई एक्स स्क्वायर, सो वी इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू एक्स स्क्वायर, एंड आई थिंक द ऑप्शन इज देयर, इजेंट इट? क्या पूछ रहा है ये? यस, सी वी इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू 1 बाय एक्स स्क्वायर, एंड द ऑप्शन इज नॉट देयर, बट यू कैन कैलकुलेट दैट दिस क्यू इज, q is what, x raised to power 3 by 2 हमने निकाला था, that is x square, and when you calculate it, it becomes x की power minus by 1 by 2, and this is becoming v directly proportional to root x. Okay, a wonderful question is for you, and this is for your homework. Please do comments the answers for this question, and please do try this question. Okay, in the next class we will discuss it first, and then we'll be marching forward the next lectures. Okay, so this module is complete for the charge. In the next module we will be talking about electric field. So till then, please do share more and more. Okay, and please comment the answers for this, and also comment the ideas or the topics over which you want the lectures. So till then, thank you so much. Goodbye.